बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू अल मुनीर हाई स्कूल ई लर्निंग सिस्टम क्लास 9। दिस इज़ योर फिज़िक्स क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर यूनिट नंबर 5। मेन टॉपिक इज़ ग्रेविटेशन, पार्ट 2 ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। दिस इज़ टाइटल पेज ऑफ योर फिज़िक्स बुक फॉर क्लास 9। लुक एट द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर 5.1, इन सर्कल द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द गिवन चॉइसेस। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, लुक एट द फर्स्ट पार्ट। अर्थ्स ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन वैनिशेस एट, सो हेयर वी हैव द फोर ऑप्शंस, सो वी मस्ट टेक और इन सर्कल द करेक्ट आंसर और करेक्ट ऑप्शन। करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज पार्ट बी, इन्फिनिटी। अर्थ्स ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन वैनिशेस एट infinity, part B. Number 2, value of G increases with the, so here we have the four options. Correct option is C, decrease in altitude. Number 3, the value of G at a height 1 Earth's radius above the surface of the Earth is, correct answer is D, 1 over 4 G. Part number 4, the value of G on moon's surface is 1.6 meter per second square. What will be the weight of a 100 kg body on the surface of the moon? Correct answer is B, 160 Newton. Next, number 5, the altitude of geostationary orbits in which communication satellites are launched above the surface of the Earth is, correct answer is C, 6400 kilometers. Part 6, the orbital speed of a low orbit satellite is, correct answer is B, 8 meter per second. So here we have the answers of all MCQs. Next, we have numerical type questions from question number 5.1 to 5.10. So here we have the solution of all the numerical type questions. Look at the statement of question number 5.1. Find the gravitational force of attraction between two spheres, each of mass 1000 kg. हमारे पास दो spheres हैं और हमने उनकी gravitational force of attraction मालूम करनी है. Mass is given. So M1 and M2 both is 1000 kg. The distance of the between the centers of the sphere is also given, which is 0.5 meters. And gravitational constant, we know about the value of the gravitational constant as we studied in our unit number 5, which is 6.673 into 10 with power minus 11 Newton meter square kg square. So we have to find out the gravitational force. What is the formula for the gravitational force? Yes, we have learned in our unit number 5 that the gravitational force formula is G M1 M2 over D square. So by putting the values of G and M1 and M2 and D2, by calculating it, we get the answer of gravitational force. So here gravitational force is 2.67 into 10 with power minus 4 newtons. Question number 5.2, the gravitational force between two identical lead spheres kept at 1 meter apart, which is 0.006673 newtons, find their masses. So in this numerical type question, we have to find the masses. So gravitational force is given. We know about the value of the gravitational constant, which is also given. Distance between the masses is 1 meter, and we have to find out the M1 and M2. So we will use the same formula to find the values of M1 and M2. We already know that M1 is equal to M2, which is equal to the larger mass M. So instead of using M1 and M2, we will use simple M. We will rearrange our formula like this, M into M over D square, D2. So m2 is over d2. So here we have to find out the m2. We will rearrange our formula. We will take the m2 on the left side of the equal and other values on the right side. By putting the values and calculating it with our calculator, we will get the mass, which is 10 with power 4 is equal to 10,000 kg each. Therefore, mass of each lead sphere is 10,000 kg. 5.3, find the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Mars. The mass of Mars is given, which is 6.42 into 10 with power 23 kg, and its radius is 3370 kilometers. So here mass of Mars is capital M with small m, represents the mass of Mars, which is given in our statement. Radius of Mars is also given. It is in kilometers, so we have to convert it into meters. So to convert the kilometers into meters, we will multiply it by 1000. Now radius of Mars is 3.37 into 10 with power 8 meters. Acceleration due to gravity of the surface, we have to find out. So here we have the formula to find the acceleration due to gravity of the surface of Mars, which is given in unit number 5. We will put the values of g, yes, mass of Mars over radius of Mars. By calculating all the values, we will get the value of gm, acceleration due to gravity of the surface of Mars, which is 3.77 meters square. Next, 5.4, the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the moon is 1.62 meters second square. The radius of moon is 1740 kilometers, and we have to find out the mass of moon. Acceleration is given. Radius of the moon is also given in kilometers. We will convert it into meters, just as we did in the above numerical. We have to find out the mass of moon. So here we have the formula. We will rearrange this formula because we have to find out the mass of Mars or mass of moon. So we will take it, the mass of moon on the left hand side of the equal and other values on the right hand side. Now we will put all these values which are given. By calculating it with our calculator, we will get the mass of moon, which is 7.35 into 10 with power 22 kgs. Next, calculate the value of g at a height of 3600 kilometers above the surface of the earth. So height is given, which is 3600 kilometers. We can convert it into meters by multiplying it with 1000. So here mass of the earth is also given, which is 6.0 into 10 with power 24 kgs. We have to find out the gravitational acceleration. It is denoted by gh. So here we have the formula for the gravitational acceleration. To find the gravitational acceleration, as we have studied in our unit number 5 about this formula, we are going to apply this formula in this numerical, because we have to find out the gravitational acceleration. Now we will put all the given values in this formula. So here we have the value of g, here we have mass of the earth, and here we have the height, the value of the height. By calculating all the values, we will get the answer, which is 4.0 meter per second square. Next, find the value of g due to the earth at geostationary satellite. The radius of the geostationary orbit is 48700 kilometers. So radius is given. Gravitational acceleration, we have to find out the gravitational acceleration with the same formula. G is equal to gme over r square. By putting the values of g, me and r square, by calculating all these values, we will get our answer, which is 0.17 meter per second square. Next, the value of g is given, which is 4.0 meter per second square. Radius of the earth is also given, which is 10,000 kilometers. When we will convert into meters, it will be 10 with power 7 meters. Mass of the earth, we have to find out what? The mass of the earth. To find the mass of the earth, we have this formula. By putting the values of g, r square and gravitational force, we know about the this value of gravitational force, which is 6.673 into 10 with power 11. So by putting the values and calculating it in this manner, we will get our answer. Next, at what altitude the value of g would become 1/4 then on the surface of the earth? So mass of the earth is given, radius of the earth, we have to know about the radius of the earth, which is 6.4 into 10 with power 6 meters. Gravitational acceleration, yes, we know about the gravitational acceleration, which is 1 over 4 into 10 meter per second square. So by calculating it, we will get 2.5 meter per second square. Altitude above the earth's surface is h. We have to find out the altitude above earth's surface. To find the altitude above earth's surface, we have this formula, as we studied in our unit number 5. So here we have to find out the r plus h whole square. So we will take it to the left hand side of the equal. Now we will take the square root on the both sides to cancel it. By taking the square root on the both sides, so here we have the r plus h and our other remaining values with the under root. Now we will apply the formula. We have to find out only the height, so we will take the r on the right hand side. When it will go on the right hand side, it will show the opposite charge or opposite sign. It will convert it into, it will show the minus sign, negative sign here in the formula. Now by putting the values in the above formula, we will get our answer. By calculating all the values of g, gme over gh, and the value of r as it is given in the above data, by calculating all these values, we will get the answer, which is minus 6.0 into 10 with power 6 meters. As height is always taken as positive, so we must ignore the negative sign here. So h will be 6.0 into 10 with power 6 meters, which is 1 earth's radius. Next, a polar satellite is launched at 850 kilometers. So it is in kilometers, we have to convert it into meters by multiplying it with 1000. So answer will be, height will be 0.85 into 10 with power 6 meters. We have to find out the orbital velocity. So to find the orbital velocity of a satellite, we have this formula. By putting the values of g, me, r and h, we will calculate all the powers of 10s. So here we have 40.038 into 10 with power 13 over 7.25 into 10 with power 6. Now after dividing it, we will get 5.55 into 10 with power 7. By calculating it again, we will get the answer, which is 7431 meter per second. Now next, 5.10. A communication is launched at 42,000 kilometers above Earth. Find its orbital speed. So height is given in kilometers. Yes, we can easily convert it into meters, which will be 42 into 10 with power 6 meters. So we have to find out the orbital velocity with the same formula as we did in the 5.9 numerical type question. By calculating the values, by putting the values of g, me, r and h, and calculating, first of all we will calculate the values of 10s, the powers of 10s, then after dividing it, we will get answer 8.27 into 10 with power 6. Now we will measure the under root. After removing the under root, we will get the value 2.876 into 10 with power 3. So answer will be 2876 meter per second. This is all for today. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.